An American congressional delegation also reaffirming Washington's support for Manila amid China's aggressive actions in the West Philippine Sea. The delegation met with President Marcos for a courtesy call Tuesday. U.S. Senator Kirsten Gillibrand told Marcos they considered the Philippines an ally and a friend. She assured the president they would help Manila push back against China's aggression.
We share your concern about China's aggression with regard to many of the issues around the Philippines. We stand with you and want to continue to stand by you and with you and to push that aggression back appropriately.
Marcos, meanwhile, thanked the U.S. delegation for taking the time to visit the Philippines in the middle of a busy election cycle.
It is particularly important, I suppose, I could say, since you have come in the middle of your rather topsy-turvy political cycle that is going on right now. But I'm happy, very happy to welcome all of you to the Philippines, and I hope that the time that you will spend here can be a productive time where we are able to discuss further the situation concerning the Philippines and the geopolitical complications that we are facing presently.
More Filipinos hurt following the back-to-back harassment from China. After Saturday's water cannon attack that left three soldiers injured, a team of scientists and divers conducting marine research in the West Philippine Sea were also subjected to harassment by the Chinese Navy. The Fisheries Bureau says a Chinese Navy helicopter hovered as low as 50 feet from the water of Sandy Cay, causing flying debris that injured the Filipino research crew. Manila's Foreign Affairs Department lodged a strong protest demanding Chinese vessels to leave the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines.
Just most recently in this incident at the Ayungan Shoal, where China harassed and also prevented our ships from, tried to prevent our ships from resupplying our troops in Ayungan Shoal, we had messages of support from over 20 countries, governments, who clearly stated the importance of adhering to international law.
As China's harassment continues, more countries are also expressing solidarity with the Philippines. Among them is India, which seeks to strengthen maritime and defense cooperation with Manila.
We are also convinced that the progress and prosperity of this region is best served by staunch adherence to a rules-based order. UNCLOS 1982 is particularly important in that regard as the constitution of the seas. All parties must adhere to it in its entirety, both in letter and in spirit. I take this opportunity to firmly reiterate India's support to the Philippines for upholding its national sovereignty.
The chief of the Philippine military visits the three Navy personnel who were injured in the latest Chinese water cannon attack in the West Philippine Sea. General Romeo Browner Jr. personally conferred medals on the troops who are being treated at the Western Command Hospital. Browner says the armed forces is coordinating with government agencies to identify adjustments that can be made in future resupply missions. He also said the military will not be deterred in performing its mandate.
Tuloy-tuloy yung ating RORE mission, no? Dahil yung DRP Sierra Madre is considered a commissioned Philippine Navy ship. At ang mga nakatao po dito ay mga sundalo ng Armed Forces of the Philippines. So it is our duty to continue bringing supplies to them, to sustain them in their operations, and to make sure that their morale, their welfare, no, is taken care of.
multiple killings in Davao City barely a week after the son of former President Rodrigo Duterte took a page out of his father's playbook and declared a war against illegal drugs. More in this report.
Seven alleged drug personalities killed in the Philippine city of Davao in a span of several days as the city's police force cracked down on illegal drugs. Last Friday, Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte issued an ultimatum to those who deal in illegal drugs that they will be killed if they don't leave the city.
I hereby declare a campaign that this city is at war against drugs.
The Davao City Police asserts the drug personalities who were killed resisted arrest. It added that pieces of evidence such as illegal drugs and guns were also recovered from the crime scene. Authorities also clarify not all suspects were killed during the operations, as some of them also surrendered.
Iklaro ko lang na prior to the statement of the city mayor, meron na tayong kampanya sa illegal contra droga. The statement of the city mayor, both our moral, both the moral of the DCP of PNP, para magtrabaho ng doble sir, no? Para ma-stop ang illegal drugs dito sa Davao City.
The Human Rights Watch expresses concern over the killings in Davao City. It calls on the Marcos Jr. administration to not let the culture of impunity continue.
In fact, now I think now the challenge now is for President Marcos to really show that he, if he is serious about, you know, the so-called new phase of the drug war, that the drug war will not be as violent as before, he needs to step in. He needs to, I think, use the might of the national government to try to rein in PNP. All the national authorities should act on this, you know, coming up. Straight from the office of the president, the Interior Department. Davao City is not some, you know, independent federal state that they can just do whatever they want. You know, it is part of the republic.
The Commission on Human Rights, for its part, says while it recognizes the gravity of the drug problem in the country, putting the law in someone's hands will not resolve the problem, as it only perpetuates the culture of impunity, violence, fear, and threat. It adds, using extrajudicial means undermines the rule of law and destroys faith in legal systems. The Davao City Mayor's father, former President Rodrigo Duterte, also implemented his own bloody anti-drug campaign during his term. Thousands were killed in what authorities claim were legitimate police encounters. The killings have triggered an investigation by the International Criminal Court. It was suspended in November 2021, but in January 2023, the ICC authorized reopening the inquiry. In July 2023, the ICC Appeals Chamber also denied the Philippine government's appeal against the resumption of the inquiry. But President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has said he does not recognize the ICC's jurisdiction and that his government will not cooperate in the ICC's investigation of the previous administration's drug war.
Let's take a look now at the situation in bus terminals in Quezon City for the Holy Week exodus. ABS-CBN's Job Manahan joins us on the line for an update for that. Job, over to you.
Hello, Bettina. Good morning. Passengers on Tuesday night flocked to bus terminals in Cubao, Quezon City to go to their provinces, saying going this early would allow them to spend more time with their families during the Holy Week. Some who went to the bus terminal said traveling on Tuesday would prevent them from the deluge of passengers expected this Holy Wednesday, the last working day for most companies and government offices this week. Among those who went to the bus terminal was Rico Bolivar, who dropped off his son. Bolivar lamented there were no special lanes for those with special needs. His sons were chance passengers to a bus going to Quezon Province. Hilda Amogues was also a chance passenger and was waiting for a bus to Aurora Province. She said she was excited to go to the province after 2 years to see her husband. Meanwhile, Ronald Aguilar and his family went to the bus station on Tuesday evening, even though their bus bound for Quezon would still leave early in the morning. Aguilar said they did not want to be stuck in the traffic. Members of the Philippine Coast Guard, Philippine National Police, and the Highway Patrol Group, Bettina, were scattered in several bus stations to ensure security and control traffic to buses entering EDSA. Bus management, meanwhile, urged passengers to avoid bringing knives or any bladed items, gas tanks, and lighters. It also reminded passengers carrying pets to bring them in cages and with diapers. Their fare will be equivalent to one passenger. Bettina.
Wow, it looks like it's going to be a busy day ahead for you, Job. Thank you very much for that update. For many Filipino Christians residing outside their hometown, Holy Week is a chance to reunite with their families and to reconnect with their faith. They participate in one of the most common religious traditions in the Philippines, the Visita Inglesa. Jeffrey Arnaiz tours one of the top local destinations Filipinos can visit this Holy Week.
Even from afar, this structure at the top of a mountain in Batangas City can be seen. But this is not just any building. This is the Monte Maria International Pilgrimage and Conference Center, where the Mother of All Asia, Tower of Peace, is located. Considered the highest image of the Virgin Mary in the world, it stands at 98.15 meters tall, or equivalent to 33 floors. Its face, which is made of bronze, was designed by national artist Ed Castrillo. One can ascend to the hand of the Virgin Mary, where the islands of Mindoro can be seen. Also here is the St. John Paul II Chapel, with a first-class relic or some pieces of hair of the former Pope.
Yung ambience niya maganda, malamig. Solemn po, ang sarap pong mag-bisita iglesia po dito.
Maganda po yung experience, maganda po yung lugar, maganda yung ambience. So punta po kayo dito sa amin sa Batangas.
Also found in Monte Maria is the Santo Niño de Praga Chapel, a replica of the Holy Infant of Prague in the Czech Republic, with a grand altar where you can pray intently while feeling the cool breeze from the sea.
Iniimbitahan po namin kayong lahat to experience the charm, the solemnity of the place. Lagi naming ini-encourage lahat ng tao na umakyat sa kamay ni Mama Mary, because there you can parang you're so close to the heart of Our Lady.
The minor basilica of the Immaculate Conception in Lipa is also frequently visited by visitors, especially during Lent for Visita Iglesia. It was established as early as 1581, destroyed and rebuilt in 1851. On April 8, 2017, parts were damaged due to an earthquake. It was temporarily closed and reopened after 8 months of renovation. Many admired the ceiling of the church, filled with murals and a golden altar. And also the black image of the Holy Child of Batangas, or the Santo Niño de Batangan, and the La Immaculada Concepcion de Batangan, or the La Batanggenya.
Ang aming pong basilica dito sa Batangas City ay mahalaga para sa amin dahil bilang mananampalataya, dito kami humuhugot ng aming pag-ibig sa Diyos at sa aming kapwa.
The church reminds the faithful to prepare themselves before doing Visita Iglesia. In addition to Visita Iglesia, the church hopes that believers will continue to visit churches and meditate, and not just during the Lenten season. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Alzar Aurelio. How's the weather looking like for the Holy Week break, Alzar?
Hello and good morning. Today and until weekend, we expect hot and humid weather condition over the whole country. Today, we expect scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Cagayan Valley, Cordillera, Aurora, Quezon, and Camarines Norte. But starting tomorrow, whole country will be experience a hot and humid weather condition, except isolated rain showers due to thunderstorms. Today, as of this moment, there's no low pressure area or tropical cyclone inside the Philippine area of responsibility, also over the West North Pacific Ocean. Today and tomorrow, forecast maximum temperature
over Metro Manila is 33 to 34 degrees Celsius. That's our weather update from Pagasa. I'm Alzar Di Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar.